Hello, my name is Stanislav. I am a manufacturer of the swivels for drilling rigs. In this video, I will show you a new model of swivel and talk about the design solutions which are used here. A swivel is used to supply flushing fluid to a rotating drill string. In our case, the swivel is also a support unit that receives loads and transfers them to the frame of the drilling rig. It can be used for flushing drilling or drilling with hammer. It uses a tapered roller bearings, hydraulic seals and stainless sleeves. The swivel is equipped with elevator. This mechanism speeds up the tripping process. And now let's take a closer look at each detail. This is how the swivel looks disassembled. All parts are covered with zinc to protect against corrosion. The body is made of a solid round bar. Here will be installed a seals. They are locking with a snap ring. And here will be installed a bearing outer ring. This is a shaft. It has a hardened stainless sleeves installed. They are made of special stainless steel, followed by hardening up to 50 Rockwell units. An outer surface of the sleeves is polished to the mirror state. In order to make a sleeves interchangeable, is carried out a grinding of the shaft and grinding of the inner diameter of the sleeve. Then the sleeve is heated and fits on the shaft. It is important not to overheat the sleeve to avoid a decrease in hardness. After installing the sleeves, the seats are machined and ground to ensure alignment. Now you can see shaft with seals and bearings installed. I made it to show how they are placed when the swivel is assembled. To ensure tightness, I used 4 sealing bearers. These are fluoroplastic sleeves, hydraulic polyurethane cuffs and rubber reinforced cuffs. This is how it looks in section. Fluoroplastic sleeves are tightened on the shaft and the body. They protect the cuffs from abrasive particles. The width of the sleeve is 16 mm and it slides tightly on the surface of the shaft. Due to this, the sand contained in water does not come into contact with the cuff. If those sleeves are not used, sand falls on the cuffs, and in the places of friction are forming grooves, and the swivel will flow. In our case, if the swivel breaks down and flows, the stainless sleeves can be replaced with new ones. So this swivel has an unlimited service life. By using fluoroplastic sleeves and stainless sleeves in couple, the seals slip on a polished stainless hard surface. During operation, the sliding points of the seals are not rusty. There is no roughness and no contact with sand. The second seal bearer is a hydraulic polyurethane cuffs. They are usually used to seal the stem of hydraulic cylinder. They hold a high pressure, so you can use a swivel with a powerful pump for water supply or a compressor for drilling with hammer. Polyurethane is a water-resistant material. Such cuffs will work for a long time without any problems. The third bearer is rubber-reinforced cuffs. These are standard cuffs with spring, and they are often used to seal shafts. The fourth bearer is exactly the same rubber-reinforced cuffs. They are installed inside the flanges and are designed to hold oil. All cavities inside the swivel, the location of the bearings, hollows of the cuffs, and all the free space are filled with oil and grease. This is sufficiently for the entire life of the seals. Very often drillers like to pump extra oil. They drill and screw the grease fittings. For these seals and for this design, you do not need to pump something. Everything has already been done. You install the swivel and work without intervention. Now let's talk about bearings. In this swivel are used tapered roller bearings. They are able to withstand heavy shocks and vibrations. They also perceive the weight of the drill string and the pressure exerted on the bit. In this design, there is no shaft play relative to the body. Here, the bearing abuts against the ledge. On the reverse side, the second bearing is tightened by two nuts. The nuts are locked with lock washers. Going further, connection to the rig. The swivel can be connected to the base plate of the carriage at the top and bottom. There are special holes for this. On this photo, you can see an example of connection the upper flange. Between the swivel and the hydraulic motor is installed a transition piece, in which there are holes for connection to the base plate of the carriage. I can make a transition piece for you. It will be compatible with your hydraulic motor. To do this, I will need the connecting dimensions of your motor. This variant of the upper connection with the dwelling rig carriage requires the sufficient mast height, since the swivel together with the elevator takes up a lot of space and it may not fit, given the length of the drill rod. It makes sense to mount the base plate at the bottom. That is, the base plate is connected using those holes. And we can save this dimension. Connection to the motor shaft. Here is used a bushing, inside which is made a hole with a keyway. The bushing is inserted into the shaft and locked with a round key. This is a universal connection that allows you to use the swivel with any rotator. I need to know the shaft diameter of your motor and the dimensions of the key to make this connection. The bushings are interchangeable. If you decide to use another hydraulic motor, you can insert appropriate bushings here. If you want to use a non-standard connection, or if you do not know yet which rotator you will use, you get a solid bushing, inside which you can make the connection yourself. Connection with drill rods. The drill rods are connected to adapter, which is screwed on the swivel shaft. The adapter is fixed using a special nut. The principle of fixation is a different direction of thread. Adapter has a right-hand thread. The nut has a left-hand thread. You need to screw the nut to the adapter, not tight, and weld them together. In this state, the adapter does not unscrew. When this thread will wear out, you can replace the adapter with a new one. To do this, you need to cut off the welding and unscrew the adapter. Initially, you get a such adapter. There are different threads which are used in drilling rigs, so I leave a place here where you can make your thread yourself. I also want to note that here are placed three nuts. They perform a different function. Two nuts are tightened the bearings. They are fixed with lock washers. The third nut is used to fix the adapter. Here it needs to be welded. You do not need to weld this nut with other nuts. Okay, let's consider the principle of the elevator. This mechanism is used to simplify work with drill rods. It allows you to raise, screw, unscrew and lower the drill rods. The elevator connects to the adapter by the locking flange. The flange is inserted in slots of the adapter and is fixed using an additional flange. We install the elevator, locking flange and screw the bolts. Ready. To hold the drill rod is used a locking mechanism. It rotates on two axes, and here inside is a locking latch. It moves in the cross direction. In this position it opens the inlet. In the other position, it fixes the drill rod. And now let's get to work. For demonstration, I will use the couplings that are used to connect the drill rods. Imagine that I am holding a drill rod. Insert the drill rod into the locking mechanism and combine the slots with latch. The latch closes and the drill rod is locked. We raise the carriage. The bar hangs on the elevator. The rotation now is locked. Insert the wrench into the drill rod and screw the bottom connection, then we lower the carriage. The elevator gets free and rotates with the drill rod. To unscrew the drill rod here, insert the wrench and unscrew the adapter. Then we lift the carriage, the elevator engages. insert the wrench and unscrew the connection at the bottom. In this way, you can carry out tripping operation with high productivity. All elevator parts are made with a large margin of stretch. The design is very simple. It can be easily dismounted and installed. To do this, unscrew the bolts and disconnect the flanges. And this is how the locking mechanism is disassembled. Unscrew the bolts and remove the lock caps. We get a latch and the axis of rotation. To make the elevator compatible with your drill rods, I need to know the dimensions of the couplings. I will make the same hole in this part and a slot in the latch. Water supply. The inlet is welded at the body. An aluminium connection is screwed on it. Another part is connected to a hose. Insert, press and turn to the right. Now they are engaged. Turn left, disconnected. You can also use an air supply to work with a hammer. The kit includes swivel, elevator, adapter, motor shaft connection, round pin, water supply connections, spare kit of seals, and lock washers. The transition piece, which is located between the swivel and motor, is not included. This is an additional option. Okay, how to order the swivel? Follow link in description and learn the information on website. There you can see my contacts. Contact me in any way and tell me the next parameters. Diameter of your motor shaft and pin dimensions. Dimensions of your drill rod connection. Dimensions of your motor connection if you want to order a transition piece. Also, I need to know your name and shipping address. I sell swivels to all countries. You can choose different shipping and payment options. If you have questions, write them in comments below. I will give a detailed answer. Subscribe channel. Good luck. Bye.